Why isn't AI really penetrating the enterprise?
Most companies didn't embrace it very readily. It took them a long time.
AI, in theory, is empowering new kinds of companies to actually exist. And then a couple of years ago, we were starting to hear a lot about AI and AI in the enterprise. And there was a lot of conversation about why isn't AI really penetrating the enterprise? What are we missing? And it seemed like what I had seen before, which was that a lot of it was tied up in the tech world. So you had this chat interface that was the primary way people would use it. And you would use this chat interface to chat with a PhD brain, artificial intelligence. And the people who spent their lives doing that mostly were people who wrote code. Your code doesn't work. You go to your PhD CTO and say, hey, fix my code.
Right.
And now you have a machine do it. Great. The rest of us in the company, that's not how we do our jobs. My marketing person does not chat with PhDs all day long for suggestions on what she should do. So it seemed like we needed a way, once again, to bring the connectivity out of the sort of the back office, the data center, and bring that as something that humans could use with AI to actually accomplish things that, using the tools that they use, using Salesforce, using Box, right, using all these different tools. And so we started Barn Door to make that a reality.
Really interesting. I think one of the things that's interesting to me too is that you were around for the API era and you saw some challenges and problems there and you started a company to try to address those.
Yeah.
It has always stuck with me that APIs in the late 2000s, there were a lot of articles about how every business leader needed to understand the API era and what's going to happen. And in a lot of ways, that never really happened.
No.
It didn't come to fruition.
No.
APIs were very useful, still are very useful.
Still are very useful.
They're a fundamental piece of technical architecture, but they're really viewed as a technology component today.
Yes.
They never really penetrated the business psyche.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's true. And part of it was there was a part of the hype cycle for APIs where the idea was you'd open an API and this army of hundreds of thousands of developers out there would build things on your thing, right? And that was all the rage. And we had this huge developer network. We had 250,000 developers that were signed up. It was great. And that happened sometimes. Mm-hmm. But really the value was large company X has APIs, large company Y, they do a partnership together. Right. They're able to, you have Citibank, you walk into a Best Buy, you use your Citibank reward card and you walk out with a TV set, right?
Right.
The behind the scenes of that, that was where APIs were really making money.
Right.
And so, the hype of it, we used to have this conference and we have to sort of explain to people what APIs were and how do you spell it. I mean, it really was tough. Fortunately, AI, at least people mostly think they know what it is.
Right.
Right. And there's still a lot of figuring out what to do with it. You're at the point now where you sort of see human processes and you are automating those. That's lovely, but that's not really where the value is going to be created. The value is created by doing things humans can't do, not just having, faster horses.
Right.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoy this podcast, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to us over on YouTube. And make sure to stay up to date with us on Apple Podcasts and Spotify as well.